to have worked. The economy is really motoring now.
Or at least that's the claim. Whether you're a sole trader with a loan or a small business trying to grow, low rates have helped you stay on track. So what will a rise in rates mean for you? The Williams family have been selling cars for four generations. Their business has survived two world wars and several economic downturns. Their luxury car showroom in the Cotswolds exports to Europe, China, and New Zealand.
We see ourselves very much as a small business selling a dream. It is a luxury product. People don't buy them for transport, but predominantly we are a small British business.
The order book here is full, thanks in part to record low interest rates.
I think we sell cars pretty much every week to someone that says, do you know what, my money's not earning me anything in the bank, so I'm going to come and buy a Morgan with it.
Well, we could have a bit of a triple whammy, really. If interest rates go up and people decide to keep their money invested rather than buying a luxury product, we would lose out a little there. We've got a huge value of stock. And if we do have to raise some funding from the bank to pay for that, it's going to cost us a lot more. But the other thing that it hits us on is on exports. We will see a change in the pound, the value of the pound. If it goes up, our inquiries coming from abroad go down. So we could be hit three times on if those rates go up.
The British Chamber of Commerce represents businesses that employ 5 million people. It has warned that the recovery is not secure and says interest rate rises would be premature.
I do stay awake at night sometimes, sort of thinking about business progression and how changes over the next few years are going to affect us and affect how we're going to look after our staff in the future. Businesses.